Dragonflight has been great so far, and many players are loving the new content, changes, and direction the expansion is going. However, will Dragonflight ultimately fail in the end? Hello everyone, it's Ego, and if you want to know my predictions for the future and whether or not Dragonflight will fail and why, stick around to the end of the video, leave a like, and sub to the channel. I've gotten a couple tunes to max level. I've done the quest lines a couple times, dungeon, renown grinding, and all that. Dragonflight has actually been quite enjoyable, I'll talk about why in a moment, but if you're still on the fence about if you should play Dragonflight, after you watch this video, go check out my video, Is Dragonflight Worth Playing?, which I'll leave a link to in the description. Now just to clarify that when I'm talking about if Dragonflight will fail, I'm of course talking about as the expansion goes on and eventually ends. We've seen it in Shadowlands where it started off strong for a majority of players, including myself, and then eventually got dry, so that's what we're going to look at. So let's look at aspects of Dragonflight that can help determine if this expansion will crash and burn like me hitting a tree on my dragon. To start off, I want to bring up a really important change that gives a little insight on possibly where Blizzard's thoughts are with World of Warcraft right now. Obviously, the company has had many ups and downs, many features that were loved by players but also hated, but Dragonflight, it feels like they are returning to the roots of what attracted people in previous versions of the game, except they've modernized it, of course. They reverted to old talent systems, which was a favorite of veteran players from the early days of World of Warcraft. These new talent trees offer some customizability for your class, which I know I really missed when they went to the little level selection system they introduced in the Cataclysm era. They probably stepped away from this to introduce some familiarity back into the game for veteran players who may be looking to return, but they did obviously add modern tweaks like talent importing, they kept PvP talents, and they made a class tree and a spec tree that you put points into. But on top of changes to the talents, they actually did a big quality of life update, allowing players to adjust their UI and really customize it for themselves. So add-ons like Bartender that managed your UI and keybinds have been actually useless for me because they took what players were needing add-ons for and instead made it an actual game feature. So the talents and the new UI changes, I like to think, is showing that Blizzard is trying to at least improve on the core of the game instead of just putting content out. Like, they're not just trying to always add new stuff right now. It seems like they're evaluating how they can improve certain game systems that are already present, if that makes sense. If you don't believe me that Blizzard actually cares about what its players think, then hang on, just bear with me here. I think they are. This is because we had a feature in Shadowlands that players enjoyed, and that was Solo Shuffle. I'm not going to explain what it is, but it's a PvP game mode. Anyways, this game mode wasn't a rated PvP game mode in Shadowlands, but many players had requested for it to be exactly that, and guess what? In Dragonflight, it is going to be. I may be giving them the benefit of the doubt, but we've got to have some hope that this isn't just a coincidence, right? The addition to rated Solo Shuffle, in my opinion, shows that Blizzard is taking into account what its player base is looking for in Dragonflight. This obviously is a big determining factor if the expansion will die out, because if your player base isn't happy, then why would they play? I could honestly be looking into this too much, but if they are actually paying attention to their players, then there's hope for Dragonflight. Let me know in the comments what you think. Another piece of the expansion that many players have noticed, I'm sure, is the attention to the zone detail. If you haven't really taken a second to look at the care that has gone into these environments, I highly encourage you to do so. Get on your dragon and fly around a little. I've seen every expansion, played every expansion, and I guarantee you that I had not seen zones that screamed to me that the artists actually truly cared. But then, as I stepped into Dragonflight, I was just blown away by the care, the detail, the immersion. It's all just so surreal. It feels like a fantasy MMORPG, like it should. So if the devs keep that up for future raids, dungeons, or whatever, then there's no doubt that aesthetically, they're not going to be failing by any means. They also seem to have taken the time to make the quests feel fun and seamless. They don't seem grindy, and the story progresses smoothly. Any side quests aren't really out of the way either. Anyone who's into questing can really get their fill. As they progress the expansion and more quests are added, I'm sure they'll feel smooth and fun like the questing has been so far. At least we can hope. So like I said, aesthetically, they're good. Questing-wise, they're good. So what about other content like dungeons? The dungeons themselves are diverse and challenging in a good way, especially in Mythic. The mechanics aren't so insane that you really can't wrap your head around them, but they're not so simple that you can really just ignore them. It sort of reminds me of older WoW, where the mechanics mattered, of course, but they're easy to manage. The dungeons are aesthetically pleasing like the zones, they fit into the storylines for each zone, and if it's a preview of what we can expect for raids, then I think we're in a good place. Though my only concern is that they make it too easy that it becomes boring, but we'll see how that goes. It's no secret that Dragonflight is the most alt-friendly expansion to ever release in World of Warcraft's history. Let me explain why. You may not realize a few of these facts. The new renown rewards are account wide. Yes, for those who didn't know this, it's true. Your renown rewards are actually account wide. If you unlock the ability to purchase a renown item on one tune, you have the ability to purchase it on another tune as well. Though you still have separate renown progressions for some non-account wide things, but they don't offer any endgame effect since it's purely cosmetic. They didn't add a grindy system like in previous expansions, but we'll talk about that. Your dragons are also account-wide. This is by far the best part about alt-leveling in Dragonflight. You can have access to a fully leveled and customizable dragon as soon as you reach the Dragon Isles, so you're not having to re-grab all the dragon glyphs or complete the storyline yet again to get access to certain dragon customizations or different dragons in general. Then of course for your alts, you have the Chromie system for leveling, which lets you choose whatever expansion you want to level in. This makes the leveling experience more enjoyable since I can run through content I actually enjoy instead of running through BFA or Shadowlands again because I genuinely do not want to do that again. All these account-wide progressions take away the sense that alts are a chore because you start from square one. Instead, you already have those progressions complete, so you're able to focus on leveling and then eventually gearing up to experience the endgame content on your new tune. This, like I said, makes Dragonflight the most alt-friendly expansion. Regardless of if you plan to make alts or not, when you get to endgame, it's great as well. The endgame of Dragonflight doesn't have any grindy systems like in BFA with Azerite or Legion with artifact power, which I really disliked. If I stopped playing for a bit, it felt like I stopped playing for an eternity. Those systems also got repetitive, constantly chasing the exact same thing. The change for this endgame content, the ability to level alts and not have to repeat everything, all these improvements and changes were done for a reason, and I believe that it's again because players were communicating their dislike for these things. If this is a small taste of how the expansion will be, and also for the future expansions, then I'm confident we've got a great journey ahead of us. So to really summarize and answer the question, is Dragonflight going to fail? Honestly, no, I don't see this expansion failing. For once in a very long time, many players are really enjoying these new features and changes. There's been lots of positivity from players, content creators, different reviews and articles, and so much more. I think Blizzard is taking a step in the right direction. I think they're listening to their player base more than they have in the past, which at the very least is a good start, and I hope that continues not only throughout Dragonflight, but for the foreseeable future. But let me know what you think down in the comments. This is a hugely debated topic, so I invite you to tell me what you think. That will be it for the video, everyone. If you made it to the end, thank you so much. You're an absolute legend, and I really appreciate it. Don't forget to drop a like before you leave, and also do me a favor, sub to the channel. It's free to do, and it shows some support. As always, thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video.